weather? Do we love traffic?
Who wants to go first?
Traffic, not so much, but
I'm loving the weather. Let's start with this nice. All right, we'll start with the good news to get you started for the morning. We are looking at a really nice day in store. You're still going to need the jacket heading out the door. It's chilly outside, but temperatures are well above average for this time of year. This is the view out in Geist, where we have mostly cloudy skies, but we're dry and Live Guardian radar clear. We're not looking at anything that's going to be moving in as we head throughout the day. This is a look at our satellite, though, and when we turn that on, what we're seeing here, these dark gray clouds, well, this is fog that's moving through central Indiana, and it is reducing visibilities through parts of the state, especially down into our south and eastern counties like Shelbyville. We're seeing reduced visibility down to a half a mile there. We're down to 6 miles in Bloomington, 7 in Indianapolis, 8 in Muncie, and 7 in Kokomo at this hour, so allow yourself a little extra time as you're heading out. Starting to look a little foggy downtown Indianapolis as well, where temperatures, we're finding them in the mid-30s. Indianapolis at 36 degrees with those winds out of the south-southwest at 5 miles per hour. A little cooler to our north. We're sitting at 32 in Cicero, 36 in Kokomo, and 41 right now in Bloomington. And as we head throughout the rest of the day, we're going to see temperatures definitely on the mild side. We're already warmer than our average high for the day. And as we head towards the lunch hour, we'll have a mix of sun and clouds around and temperatures rising into the mid-40s. We'll see temperatures rise into the low 50s before we start to drop again late this afternoon, right around 3-4 o'clock. Here's a look at Fox Futurecast, keeping those clouds around, mixed in with that sunshine as we head throughout the afternoon. And then we'll start to see some fog developing once again once we head towards the late evening hours and into your early Wednesday morning. Wednesday starts soft dry, but this is where we're starting to see things shaking up with our weather pattern. This is what we're looking at 7 a.m. Wednesday morning, and as we head towards the late morning hours, we'll start to introduce some chances for some widely scattered showers around, and then those lingering throughout the afternoon. Not everybody gets wet, and we're not talking a lot of rain, but as this clears out behind it, what we are talking about is a lot of cold air. So where we're dealing with southwesterly winds today, we'll have another warm front that will bring us even warmer temperatures as we head into Wednesday afternoon. And then it's followed by a cold front that's really going to drop temperatures down. This is our first shot of cold air that we're tracking this week, and it's going to drop temperatures down to more of a seasonal feel. This will open the doors to where we could see some snowfall. So far, our seasonal snowfall well below average, more than an inch below average, and we haven't had any measurable snow for January. This makes it the least snowiest January since 2007. Now we are looking at chances for snow as we head towards late in the week, so temperatures drop from the mid-50s on Wednesday into the mid-30s, much closer to the seasonal average high Thursday into Friday. Friday, we're looking at chances for some snow changing to rain, so any snow that does fall isn't going to last very long. Temperatures rise into Saturday before they fall early in the day. It's going to be windy, it's going to be wet, and much colder behind it, starting off in the teens as we get into early Sunday and Monday morning, and then temperatures only rising into the mid-20s. Katie?
Thanks, Krista. Just over 10 minutes.